The lawyer jirga, the grand assembly of several thousand Afghan council elders, is right now considering a long-awaited security pact with the US. The deal would see up to 15,000 American troops staying in the country beyond 2014. But what powers would they have? President Karzai says he doesn't trust the Americans, but still he is urging the delegates to accept the deal. Karen Allen is in Kabul for us.
Security is extremely tight here in Kabul. The city is on virtual lockdown. Many businesses are closed. And there was a bomb blast just a few days ago that killed 10 people. There is a sense of nervousness today. We're not even allowed to film the police and their additional presence here. All this because there is a major gathering of tribal elders, some 2,500 men and women, a meeting just behind here and being asked to consider a vital security pact between the US and Afghanistan. That pact will effectively set the terms under which US forces will be allowed to remain in Afghanistan after next year. But there's been a lot of legal wranglings over the exact terms under which they're allowed to remain. One of the key sticking points has been the right for US troops to be able to mount raids on Afghan homes. Accessing homes has been a highly sensitive issue throughout the war. There's also the issue of immunity for American soldiers. Will they be tried in courts back in the United States? Here, away from the lawyer jirga, there's very mixed feelings about the very fact this meeting's been held at all. This gathering is a waste of time and money. It's costing the Afghan government and people a lot, and it's creating problems for Afghan security and the economy. President Karzai has already said the Americans are not pulling out of Afghanistan. The Afghan government's done nothing but sell our country out. Although the meeting of the tribal elders is not legally binding, President Karzai is trying to get the widest possible mandate for what is a critical decision that will have impact on future generations in Afghanistan. If there is no deal, the Americans could simply pull out and walk away from Afghanistan altogether.
Karen Allen there in Kabul. While the office of President Karzai has just in the past few hours released a letter from President Obama saying how pleased he is they have reached an agreement. In the letter, President Obama says America's role will be one of supporting partner and a sovereign Afghanistan will be responsible for its own security. He also says the US forces shall not enter Afghan homes except under extraordinary circumstances involving urgent risks to US nationals. Interestingly, he pointed that out. That's been a key sticking point for many people in Afghanistan. Well, let's take you live now to Istanbul. We are joined by Barry Pavel from the Atlantic Council. He is a former National Security Council staffer serving under both President Bush and President Obama. Thank you very much for being with us. How concerned will the US be right now about the timing of this security deal? President Karzai now saying it won't be signed until after elections in April.
Well, I noticed that too, and I think that's probably fine. I think our forces will proceed on a path as if everything will work out as apparently very recently mutually agreed. And so April of 14 gives us time to continue on the glide path to the end of 2014 and then the new agreement on how our 2015 and beyond presence will be governed and the types of priority missions that they'll be engaging in.
Do you think right now U.S. officials are also a bit worried about the fact this has to go not only through the lawyer jirga, but then through Parliament as well, and that there might be some other issues that come up and changes that they insist on?
I think you're right. I mean, this isn't the beginning of the end, but it's the end of the beginning, to quote a famous British statesman. So yes, it's a longer process. It goes to the lawyer jirga. Changes can be made there. It then goes to the Afghan parliament, and changes can be made there. And then the White House has a say on whether it agrees with those changes or not. Then it might start the process again if there are some new issues to be resolved in light of the changes that the aforementioned phases of the process would engender. So yes, this could be a longer process, and we'll see what happens.
Are there any changes, though, that the Afghans could insist on that would be a deal breaker for the U.S.?
Yes, well, I think even the wording that's been agreed on regarding U.S. combat operations, where I think it's, you know, it requires, quote, mutual agreement, unquote, with the Afghans, I think that's an interesting issue. It's workable. but sort of who has to agree, how fast would they agree if there's rapidly developing threats, sort of what's the process. I think that can be worked out, but I think that could become a sticking point if it ends up taking time and hampering military operations or putting U.S. service members, allied service members at risk. So that's something to be watched.
And Barry, what does it actually do to bilateral relations between America and Afghanistan when President Karzai says today, I don't trust the Americans?
Well, in some ways it's mutual. I mean, there's good aspects of any relationship and bad aspects. I think in general it's a decent agreement for both sides, where it gives the U.S. what it wants, which is, you know, some foundation for preventing or at least limiting the ability of Afghanistan to be used once again as a safe haven for plotting terrorist attacks. And the Afghans, it gives some sense of U.S. military presence that will help keep the billions of dollars in foreign aid flowing and helping the Afghan government to stand itself up and build the institutions that are required for a functioning society.
So very briefly,
in general, the contours are good.
Very briefly, Barry, how long do you think the U.S. should commit to keeping troops there?
Well, I mean, I think what I read was the agreement goes out to 2024, but I also read that a senior official said there is no way that we will be retaining a presence that long. It's up to the next president in some ways, so we'll see how forces go. We still have forces in Bosnia after how many years? There's still forces in Kosovo, so these things tend to be sticky.
Barry Pavel, thank you very much for joining us from Istanbul. Thank you.